गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
ओके सो योर थर्ड चैप्टर ऑफ दिस मॉड्यूल इज कल्टीवेशन ऑफ मलबरी। आई थिंक यू ऑल नो व्हाट इज अ मलबरी बुश, राइट? इट इज अ डेसीडियस प्लांट विच गिव्स वेरी नाइस फ्रूट। द फ्रूट कैन बी इधर व्हाइट इन कलर, रेड इन कलर, black in color, okay, depending upon different environmental conditions and the variety of mulberry that you rear, okay. And these fruits are having antioxidant properties. They are very good for human health also. Even the leaves are used for making tea and all those things, right? But today we are going to study mulberry cultivation not for human beings but for silkworm, okay. So agricultural part of sericulture is called as mori culture or mulberry cultivation. So the cultivation of mulberry to get good quality leaf for feeding the larvae during the process of sericulture is called as mori culture. Okay, so mori culture is mulberry cultivation. Now we know that mulberry silkworm is monophagous insect. Monophagous means it feeds on only one type of plant. Monophagous, only one type of plant. It will feed only on mulberry, that is Morus. The genus Morus is mulberry. So mulberry silkworm will feed on genus Morus only. So different species and varieties of Morus. So there are many varieties, many species belonging to genus Morus. So it will feed on all those, but it prefers the white mulberry. It prefers the white mulberry Morus. Now many attempts were made to find a substitute for mulberry plant. So what was done is different plant leaves as an experimental basis was given to the silkworm to see what happens. But the silkworm that they got was smaller in size. The cocoon was also very small and the quality of silk was not good. So you cannot substitute mulberry leaf with any other leaf. This is first thing. Second one is in Japan, they tried to develop polyphagous varieties. Polyphagous means which can feed on different type of leaves. Okay. So they tried to develop polyphagous silkworms so that it can feed on any leaf. But even then, again, they found the same problem. The hybrid polyphagous varieties of silkworm, they were not giving the same quality and quantity of silk. So this experiment also failed. Okay, so you cannot substitute mulberry leaves. You cannot go for polyphagous varieties because you will not get good quality still. So additional third one, what they did was in Japan only, they manufactured artificial dye. So even if a person is not having field in a small room, he can start his sericulture and he can give artificial dye. One benefit of artificial dye is that you save labor on cultivation, you save labor on bed changing, bed cleaning, cutting off leaves, bringing the leaves and feeding to the larvae. All these you will save labor. But whatever labor you are saving, that same amount of money you will have to spend on the artificial dye. So cost effectively, if you see, it is one and the same thing. So you can go for artificial dye, but it is not popular in India. It is not used in India, okay, but in Japan it is used extensively. Now whatever amount of profit that you get in sericulture, 60% of your profit is used only in cultivation of mulberry. So if you get a profit of 100 rupees, 60 rupees you are going to use for mulberry cultivation, and remaining 40% only you will be getting in your hand, from which you will have to spend on labor, etc. Okay, so you can see how important mulberry cultivation is. Now there are many varieties of mulberry plants which can be cultivated depending upon the soil type. So if the soil is loamy, sandy, clay, red soil, laterite soil, different types of soil are there all over India. So depending upon that, you will have to select your mulberry plant. Okay, then climatic conditions are also important, whether it is warm or whether it is cold. If it is Himalayan region, you need a different one. If it is Deccan region, you will need a different variety. And rainfall also, because some varieties are can grow in areas where there is no irrigation and only rainfall is there. And some varieties will die. The plants will die if you plant them in such areas, and they will not give good yield also. So depending upon the climatic condition, soil type, you will have to decide which plant you are going to grow. Now, when mulberry silkworm synthesizes silk, it is called as biosynthesis because it is synthesized by a living organism, right? So biosynthesis of silk by silkworm depends on the mulberry leaf protein. Okay, so mulberry leaf protein is accumulated by the silkworm larvae, and it uses that only for the synthesis, biosynthesis of silk. Now, two types of proteins are present in silk fibers: fibroin and sericin. Now, fibroin are two which come through the spinneret, and these two fibers are stuck together by sericin to make a single silk fiber. So these two proteins are present. Now, in most part of India where the climate is warm, mulberry is grown as a bush. So you trim it and keep it at a low level as a bush. And in some Himalayan regions where the climate is cold, it is grown as middlings and trees. Okay, so you can middlings will be at a higher height, and trees, proper trees are there, so harvesting becomes a bit difficult. You will have to cut the branches for harvesting them. Now mulberry is grown, and rearing of silkworm is done almost in 26 countries. Some countries have increased in production, some have decreased in production. We'll just take an overview of it. Now, this is about Asia. Wherever I have put a tick mark, those are the places where you will find mulberry cultivation. So you can see tick mark on India, right? So here mulberry cultivation throughout India, it is done. Then Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, Afghanistan, China, South Korea, Japan, USSR. Previously, Russia, Kazakhstan, Uzbekistan, Turkmenistan, Kyrgyzstan, and Pakistan, all these together were called as USSR. Okay, but after they broke down, after they split up into different countries, one Russia is large one, and these are the smaller ones. So when we say USSR, it means Russia and these smaller countries previously, which were together. All right. So in all these places, you will find that there is mulberry cultivation. Then Japan. Okay. Then Syria is here. This is Syria. Then this is Iran. Okay. This is Thailand here. You can see Indonesia here, and Cambodia you can see here below Thailand. Okay. So these are the countries in Asia. Now countries of Europe, if you see, you can see here Hungary. So Hungary is here. This is Hungary. Okay. Then you have Greece here. This is Greece. Then Turkey. This is Turkey. Then Romania. This is Romania. Bulgaria is below Romania. Then Spain, you can find Spain here, France here, okay. Then Italy, this a narrow strip is Italy. Then Poland here. So these are the places in Europe. In addition, you also find mulberry cultivation extensively in Egypt. that is in North Africa, Brazil, in South America. Now, varieties for cultivation. Now, there are, when you are selecting a variety for mulberry cultivation, what are the things that you have to see in it? It should have good root system. So that root will penetrate deep inside the soil and it will give good growth to the plant. Then second point is high leaf yield. The mulberry plant should give good amount of leaf because you need it to feed the larvae. It should have the ability to adapt to various environmental conditions and soil types. It should be resistant to diseases. It should have excellent leaf quality because leaf quality is good, then the silk quality will also be good. Then leaf production should be in different rearing seasons because whenever you are rearing, you need to get leaf. Now, these are the mulberry plants that are grown in India. So, morphological features, if you see, we have some foreign or exotic varieties which we have brought into India and some are Indian varieties. So, exotic or foreign varieties are Morus bombicis, Morus alba, Morus latifolia. Most of them are originally from China and Japan only. An indigenous variety is Morus indica. This is originally from India only. It was found in the Himalayan regions and it is called as Nooni tree. It is called as Nooni tree. Then Morus serrata and Morus levigata are other varieties which you will find in Assam and other places. Now, let us see some of them. Morus bombicis. So leaf surface is poor in luster. So the leaf surface is not shining. It is not shining. The leaves are either lobed. So here you can see the leaves are lobed. But here you can see one leaf which is not lobed. So the leaves can be either lobed or not lobed with acute serrations. Okay, so serrations, the side, these cuttings like this, okay? So these are the serrations. These serrations are very acute. You can see them clearly, all right? And bark is yellowish brown in color. So here in picture, you cannot see because this is the terminal end. But here slightly, you can see it is yellowish brown bark. Now, second is Morus alba. Here, the leaf surface again is poor in luster. It is not shining. The leaf can be either lobed. So, this is the lobed leaf. This is without lobe. And these are modifications of the same. So, you can have any type. And they have blunt serrations. So, these serrations which you see, they are not very deep, very accurate. They are blunt. Female flowers with short style which is not prominent. Okay, so if you see the fruiting, you will not find a thread like structures like this. That means style is very short and you cannot see. Here if you see in Morus bombicis, you find that the style is long. So on the fruit, can you see these thread like structures, long thread like structures on the fruit? These are the style. So here style is the female reproductive part of flower, right? So style is very long in bombicis, but in alba it is not long. It is very short. You cannot see it. Now, Indian varieties, if you see Morus indica, which is called as Nooni tree, the Mysore local is originally from Karnataka. It is also a local variety originally from Karnataka, from which also many different varieties have been produced. So both are variations. If the thing is that this you will find in the Himalayan region and this you will find in the Karnataka. Okay. These pictures I have taken from net. It was clicked by Dinesh Walke. So I have mentioned his name here. So here also you will find the fruit is small in size and it can be it is light in color, and here also the style is medium to large in size. Now Morus serrata. So this is again a native to Himalaya, southwest China. It grows at high altitude, mountain region. So you can see 2300 meters height, you will find it. It is small deciduous tree, growing almost 50 meters, 15 meters tall. The leaves are 10 to 14 centimeter long, 6 to 10 centimeter broad, quite big, densely hairy. Densely hairy. So you'll find hair on the veins underneath the leaf, means lower surface of the leaf you will find hairs, but on the upper surface you will not find hair. The fruit is quite long, 2 to 3 centimeter long. Other mulberry varieties show short fruits, but this variety has long fruit. It is red color when ripe, and it is considered as a variety of white mulberry, Morus alba, and similar to black mulberry, Morus nigra. Morus nigra, black mulberry. Morus alba is white mulberry. This is intermediate, red in color, but it shows characters of both. So we have seen two Indian varieties and two foreign varieties. You have to remember the names of these mulberry. Now, the Central Silk Board of India and State Silk Board of India. Different states have their own state silk board. Maharashtra also has its own state silk board situated at Nagpur. Okay. So each state has its own silk board and one central silk board for all over India. They have done different experiments and have come to the conclusion regarding these particular species of mulberry are good at these particular places. So in Karnataka, they have suggested hybrid varieties DD. The name DD comes from the variety that you find in the Dune Valley of Uttaranchal. Then TGM5. Hilly areas, northeastern areas or other hilly areas, TR10, BC259, POSEN are good. KPJ11 and Morus Indica are also good, but at all these places you will find people prefer POSEN, people prefer Morus Indica, and they don't go for the others. Then in West Bengal, Mandale, it is also called as S1, then Berhampur, S799, they are preferred, they have been recommended. Then in Himachal Pradesh, Jammu and Kashmir, MR2, Sujanpur 5. In Nagaland, it is K2. Assam, it is Assam Bola. In UP, it is S146. In Tamil Nadu, Mysore Loker, then Mysore 5, then MR2. MR stands for mildew resistant variety. So mildew is a disease that occurs in the mulberry plant. So this particular variety is resistant to mildew. So mildew resistant is MR2. Okay, V is for victory. V1, it is the most popular variety which gives maximum yield. So MR2 and V1, these are very popular varieties. And if, not only Tamil Nadu, but other places also you will find people going for that. Now we will segregate all these mulberry varieties into three categories. So first is local or indigenous variety. So previously, there was only one variety called as Mysore local or local, and it was cultivated in Karnataka, Tamil Nadu and all the South Indian area. It was known as Natikaddi also. It is suitable for both irrigated and non-irrigated farms. Now, irrigated farms means where you can supply water to the field throughout the year because you have bore wells, river, you have a source of water with you and you can supply water throughout the year. So that is irrigated. And non-irrigated means you don't have source of water. You cannot supply water throughout the year, and only in the rainy season, because of rains, the crop will grow. Okay, so non-irrigated means only in rainy season. Irrigated means throughout the year. All right. So this is suitable for both types, and if you are going for good agronomical practices, then you get good yield. Okay, about 8,000 to 25,000 kg of leaf you get per hectare per year. Okay. Why so much variations? Because if it is 8,000 is for non-irrigated, you get only one crop in the rainy season, and 25,000 is for the irrigated condition where you can get four crops a year, right? Now these are the improved varieties or hybrid varieties. So Kanwa 2 is very popular. It is hybrid of Mysore local. It can be cultivated in different types of soil and climate. It is popular in almost all Indian states, and leaf yield is also very good, 30,000 to 35,000 kg per hectare per year. Okay, so compared to Mysore local, almost double amount of leaf you are getting. Now second one is MR2 or mildew resistant variety, very popular variety. So powdery mildew disease, it is resistant to powdery mildew disease. It is better suited for high altitude and good rooting. All right, so wherever the altitude is slightly more hilly regions, it is more suitable for those places. Now it has excellent growth rate, and leaf yield is about 25 to 30 kg. The leaf has lots of proteins and moisture content. So the drawback is, because it has more nutritional value, it is susceptible to the insect pest called as thrips. Now these are the high yielding varieties of irrigated crops. So these are improved varieties we have seen. These were for non-irrigated. This is for irrigated cultivation, means where you supply water throughout the year. So Vishwa is DD. We have seen it was found in the Doon Valley of Uttaranchal. It has good root system and fast growing. It yields 5 to 6 harvests in a year. If you give it sufficient amount of fertilizer and you give it regular water supply, then you get very bumper crop. 40,000 to 45,000 kg of leaf you can harvest per year, per hectare. The second one is Victory 1. It is again a fast growing variety with high rooting and good sprouting. The leaf is dark in color, succulent, soft. The leaves are thick with high moisture content, and they remain fresh for a long time. So this is preferred. So moisture content is good, then nutrient content is good, and you get a bumper crop, 60,000 kg per hectare per year. Okay, so this is preferred. This is very popular, big tree. So for non-irrigated, Kanwa is popular, and mildew resistant variety is popular. For irrigated, you have Vishwa and Victory. Then we have high yield varieties for rain fed or non-irrigated, S13 and S34. So here also, this is non-irrigated, so you get a very little amount because you are getting leaf in only one season, only in the rainy season. So you are getting only 18,000. Okay, whereas in irrigated you are getting 60,000, because there you are getting leaf throughout the year. You are getting four crops. You are getting only one crop. Okay. Then S34. This also is good for black cotton soil, and you get around 80,000 leaf per hectare per year. Okay, so we end up with our mulberry cultivation part 1.